This is Wayne County Treasurer Raymond Vojtovich. The county's tax foreclosure property auction will take place September 16th through September 22nd. To participate, bidders must register by September 9th. Due to the record number of properties, the county will hold the auction online at bidforassets.com. Purchasing Wayne County property represents real investment, real ownership, real Michigan at work.
It's the countdown to the all-new Ultimate 50-50 Raffle from the Michigan Lottery. The return of the raffle with a jackpot that's growing with every ticket sold. Counting down to the drawing September 29th, when one lucky player wins it all. But there's more. Now, Ultimate 50-50 Raffle has five weekly $25,000 bonus drawings. So buying early also means extra chances at 25 grand. Get your ticket today.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to WADL TV 38. This is Detroit Wants to Know. During our last segment, we met Cliff Averill, a 25-year-old African-American young man who's slugging it out on the football field, going back to school, and just doing things which are the antithesis of which we've read in the papers over the last few weeks. This is a black man moving in a positive direction who's only 25. But in Detroit, there are actually opportunities for young men to start off on the Cliff Averill Road. And I want to introduce you to one of those opportunities. My main man, William Tandy, the coach of the West Side Cubs.
How you doing, Steve?
And who's this you have with you here?
This is Tony, one of my wide receivers from the West Side Cubs.
Is he really in eighth grade?
Yes, he is. He just finished eighth grade, 14-year-old. He's going to be one of our wide receivers. Hopefully he will matriculate to post-secondary institution and do well in college and go forward and change the environment and change his family.
Tony, how tall are you?
I'm 6'3 and a half.
6'3 in eighth grade. Did you eat a lot of McDonald's as a young child? That's just amazing to me. William, the West Side Cubs were started 57 years ago?
Absolutely.
Okay, tell me about that.
1957,
they were started. Were they always at McCabe Field?
Yes, we were always in that area. The West Side Cubs is actually the first football program in the country that started with a diverse group of students, diverse group of young men. 1957, we started, we played right at McCabe Field, and we've been there ever since, doing well.
So tell me, what kind of players have come through there? I know my brother was a West Side Cub, Benny Napoleon was a West Side Cub, but who else?
You've had a plethora of individuals.
Does he use words like that in practice, a plethora? Anyway, go ahead.
You had a group of young men from Reverend Nicholas Hood, your mm-hmm. brother, Wendell Anthony. Right now we have...
Wendell Anthony played football?
Yes, Wendell Anthony played for the West Side Cubs.
What did he play, left out?
I have no idea. But also we have Larry Foote mm-hmm. from the Pittsburgh Steelers. We have Braylon Edwards from San Francisco 49ers. Mm-hmm. Willie Horton, all-American baseball player. Mm-hmm. There are a number of greats that have played for the Cubs that are playing in the NFL now and also that are playing in college today. Edwin Baker, our tailback at Michigan State, and tight end Deion Sims. Outside linebacker, USC, Nick Perry, the top two all-staters for the Michigan right now at Cass Tech, our West Side Cubs, James Ross, Orchard Lake, St. Mary's that's going to Michigan. Mm-hmm. So we have a number of young men that are doing well on and off the football field.
Okay, now how many teams does West Side Cubs have? There's A team, B team, C team?
There are four teams. We have a ninth grade team, seventh grade team, fifth grade team, third grade team, as you would know it as the A, B, C, and D teams.
Now, what do you teach these young men in addition to the football skills? I know football teaches teamwork. It teaches getting to practice on time. It teaches athletics. But what else are you teaching?
Well, our motto is GBB, which stands for?
God, Books, and Ball.
So it's
God, Books, and Ball.
Absolutely. That's our motto.
Not GHB, GBB. God, Books, and Ball.
That's
continue.
Right. So spirituality first, your education second, and football third. It's nowhere in the world a young man is going to get off of Rochester and Dexter by just playing football. He's got to be able to pass his ACT. He needs to be one with his spirit. He needs to be productive. He needs to be responsible. Mm-hmm. And that's what we're teaching them there first. And we happen to be great on the football field as well. That's why we continue to win a number of championships.
What was your record last year?
9-1. 9-1. We got upset in the semifinals going into the championship. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. Now, how many kids do you have on the combined these four teams?
About 200 kids in total.
200
about
kids
200
in
kids
total?
About 200 kids in total, correct.
Well, how do you marshal that?
Well, you know, it's difficult, Steve. And
I mean,
this
you must
climate,
have a lot of parent involvement.
You know, we used to. Mm-hmm. Right now, with the plight of the city and a lot of the individuals that come to us, our first generation low income, and we don't have the support that we normally have. So a number of the kids can't pay mm-hmm. the registration. A number of the kids are getting up there on their own, or coaches are picking them up. So we're trying to save that area and save those young men. So it is difficult.
If people want to donate to the Westside Cubs, how do they do that?
Oh, absolutely. They can call 313-478-6150, and we can send them the information.
478-6150.
Correct.
Okay.
And they can definitely call, and we'll give them the address to where they will send the money. And we're located at 4400 West Boston Boulevard mm-hmm. in Detroit between Dexter and Broad.
Now, if people want to come to the games, what time are they?
12 noon.
12 noon on Saturdays?
On Saturdays.
And so it's a whole afternoon of football?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Great football.
I saw your cheerleaders. You have a guy that does tumbles and all that
absolutely.
Stuff?
Absolutely. They've been winning national championships. They go all over the country and cheer, and they've been doing great. Our cheer program is outstanding.
Okay.
So it's young men and young ladies.
Okay, give us that number one more time before we go
313-478-6150.
Ladies and gentlemen, when we come back, we're going to continue our discussion with Willam Tandy, because he does something in addition. He has a day job in addition to coaching the Westside Cubs. This is Steve Hood, Detroit Wants to Know, TV 38. I think we found your solution to crime.
The Plymouth Educational Center, serving kindergarten through high school, has campuses near Wayne State and in the New Center area.
Plymouth Educational Center is committed to educating the whole child.
PEC educates students to become lifelong learners with average class sizes of 25. Students get the personal attention needed to succeed.
I love math, social studies,
and science.
At PEC, success is the only option. Give your child the PEC advantage. Call 313-831-3280.
Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. You're watching TV 38 WADL. My guest this afternoon is Willam Tandy. Willam, we were talking about the Westside Cubs before, but you also do something with Wayne State, your day job. Tell us about the Upward Bound program.
Upward Bound is designed to take first-generation low-income students that want to matriculate to college. And what we do is we provide...
There goes another big word, young man.
We provide tutorial services, but most importantly, we also expose these young men and young ladies to colleges throughout the country. A young person can't become what they can't see. So it's imperative for them to meet lawyers, engineers, doctors. It's imperative that they see the campus of the University of Michigan, Morehouse, Howard. Mm-hmm. So we will send these kids to historical black colleges and universities mm-hmm. throughout the country, as well as the other colleges. And we give them everything that they need, including a six-week residential program where they can come on Wayne State's campus. They take classes at Wayne State. They live on the dorms. So the students are away from their mothers and expose what it's like to be away in college.
That's amazing.
Yes.
How do you get in touch with the Upward Bound program?
313-577-1943
mm-hmm.
or www.wayne.edu
okay.
And go to the Upward Bound.
All right.
Site. Yeah.
Now, young man, you're in eighth grade. Give me your name again.
Tony Montgomery.
Mr. Montgomery, let me ask you this question. As an eighth grader, how do you avoid trouble?
Really, when you just keep up on your books and just... You know, you just gotta stay away from the wrong people, cause you always can tell when people up to trouble. So, just go to class, come home, go to practice, and you'll be all right.
That's awesome. What about playing video games? Do you play many video games?
Cause
I hear that people in your generation, your 8th grade generation, are so busy playing video games, they're not athletic enough. Do you suggest that people get more athletic and get away from the video games?
Yeah, well, really, me personally, I don't really play video games. Most of my free time is done. I'm doing homework or I'm at practice.
Okay, that's awesome. Willam, sounds like you're doing a great job. Can you give us once again how to donate to the Westside Cubs?
Absolutely. You can call 313-478-6150, and we will give you the information. And our website is westsidecubs.org. And just please, you know, we're out here doing a lot of work with young kids, and it takes a lot of money, any kind of donation, even time, would be very appreciative.
Okay, I want to switch gears with you for a second. You and I grew up, we were in high school together. Correct. And all that. With the rate of change that you've seen in Detroit, is there hope for the future?
Absolutely. Okay. Absolutely. There is hope for the future. You know, we beat ourselves up. We beat ourselves up more than anything else. And I think all we have to do is stay focused on getting kids in school, exposing kids, and with them, everything can change. Absolutely.
What do we do about this crime problem? I mean, you got one great solution here. The West Side Cubs is a great solution for the fall, but there are only 200 kids in there. You got a lot more than 200 kids in the city. And I know there are little football teams all around.
Right, throughout AYFL and other programs. What we need to do is find programs and get our kids in those programs. It starts at home, Steve. If we can get our parents to buy in, we can get everything else done. But if the parents don't buy in, we need to be more interactive and go out and make the changes. You're involved. I'm involved. Mm-hmm. But how many of our friends are not involved?
They were talking about hydrangeas yesterday. I was partying with some of them losers.
Right.
Really? But I mean, I have this kind of bush. I have that kind of bush.
Right. But think about it, Steve. We've had a number of individuals in our own group that are very successful. How many are out there bringing these kids back, and how many are out there involved? Mm-hmm. I have kids living in my home that are not my children. Mm-hmm. That I helped raise, not through the foster care system, not for money, but just to help out. And if we all did that, it'd change everything.
Now, I understand you're a new father now.
Absolutely. I have a little three-year-old. Her name is Lauren Nicole. She's beautiful.
So it's not a boy.
It's a girl.
Thank God the city's safe. That's impressive. Tell us once again how to donate to the West Side Cubs.
If you want to donate to the West Side Cubs, please dial 313-478-6150. We're a 501c3 nonprofit organization, so we can give you the correct address that you can get all of the information donated to us.
One more thing. You're on the northwest side of Detroit. We did a show from Mike's Fresh Market. Okay. What's the neighborhood like up there now?
You know what? Palmer Woods, Sherwood, Forest University District is great. You know,
because we read about all the foreclosures going on and all that stuff.
Yeah, but you know what? What it's doing is it's giving a lot of individuals an opportunity to upgrade. You can look at this one or two ways. You can be down about it, mm-hmm. or you can short sell your home and upgrade. You can do different things. So the neighborhood is great. I love the neighborhood. I love the city of Detroit. You know my wife is not going to let me go, even if I wanted to go. Mm-hmm. So we're here for the long run.
Okay. Willam Tandy, he's one of the stalwarts of Detroit. We now know we have another solution to our crime problem, and it starts early. Get them into organized sports. Get them moving forward. And one more time, give me that donation number for the West Side Cubs.
313-478-6150.
Ladies and gentlemen, you have a solution. This is Steve Hood. You're watching Detroit Wants to Know. We're on WADL TV 38. You can always hit me up at stevehooddetroit.com or hit my Facebook page. I respond to all comments and queries. Have a great week. And if you get a chance, next Saturday, McCabe Field, 12 noon, go watch some football. Donate to the West Side Cubs. Have a great week, ladies and gentlemen, and a great holiday.
People moving out, people moving in. Why? Because of the color of their skin.
Run, 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 but you sure can't hide.